But I digress. So, I don't use the N-word in public. Because it's a black call. But by being offended and outraged, you know, I just, it's just my personal opinion. I think you guys are fucking it up. I do, that's just my opinion. Because black guys, black people, by being offended and outraged by that word, you are not taking it off me. You are giving it to racists. And no matter how far you come as a people, that southern redneck, Bible-bashing, tobacco-chewing, get-her-done fucking hick, that dull-witted motherfucker that throws a brick through a pediatrician's window every time he read there was a pedophile operating in the area, that dumb cunt still has that word. And you've given it to him. You've given it to him gift-wrapped. But I accept the world I'm living within, but you know what? We have the power to change the history, the subtext, and the meaning of that word forever. Forever! In a matter of seconds. And the answer lies in the British House of Lords. Because the British House of Lords is, without a doubt, the whitest governing body in the world. Even other white nations look at the British House of Lords with their bright red jackets and their archaic, ludicrous white wigs as they're spouting off at one another incomprehensibly, just blah, blah, puffy cheeks, tea cozies, great big bags of spoons, great big bags of spoons. And even other white nations are going, fuck, that's white. Just once in the British House of Lords, when they were all kicking off at one another and just going, Mr. Speaker, I ask of you, sit down, sir, for shame, for shame. Just once, the Speaker of the House goes, order, 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 niggers, please. Who didn't think I could make that funny? Who didn't? And relax.